Dude, so I have in front of me the craziest electrical panel I've ever seen. So Schneider Electric sent this to me. It's a square D panel, but what's cool about it is it's like a multi-use panel. So it's a meter enclosure, it's a load center, and it has hookups for alternative power sources. So if you have solar, if you have generators, things like that, you can actually hook up, and it's all in one box. So we're doing an unboxing. So most of the time when you have an electrical panel out on the outside of your house, right, your electrical service comes out there, most of the time you're going to have a meter enclosure, meaning an entire enclosure just for this meter to stab into, separate. Then you're going to have maybe a main disconnect, which might be another enclosure with one huge breaker in it. You could have another electrical panel out there if it's not like a main breaker kind of panel, or you might have multiple different panels out on your service. And then once you start getting complexity in the system and you start adding solar, you could have all of this solar stuff all over the wall. People are starting to do backup battery power, UPS power, or generators. So they've got like an automatic transfer switch or a manual transfer switch. It just gets to be where this service is like taking up like 20 feet of wall. This thing is a 200 amp energy center by square D. This is specifically for new construction. So this is not a remodel box, and that's something that they're developing right now. So they do have plans to put something together that's maybe meant for interior applications or remodel applications, but this is more for new construction out on the outside of a house. So let's break into it. You can see first we have a utility meter obviously in the same enclosure, but there is separation, so you can open up this little cavity and you can see down, you know, this is where your service entrance conductors are going to come into the meter. You can see there's definitely separation there, and they give you holes all the way up to 3 inch, which is really nice, so you don't have to try to, you know, pop in bigger holes than you normally would. This is 200 amp rated, by the way, so it's 200 amp single phase specifically, not for three phase, not yet at least. I like these little like knob things that they have. This is really secure, so it's not, I mean, this thing's heavy duty, like really, really well constructed. All of Square D stuff is really well constructed. I think Square D is the best out on the market. I pretty much exclusively use them, except for if there's like budgetary constraints or something like that. But they even have the home line system, so they have like a little bit more price conscious version of their stuff if people don't want to go with QO. But anyways, all QO stuff is really well engineered. So I like these little knob things. They feel really secure, and you don't have to like have a screwdriver to try to open something and close something. I just really like that. Check this out, dude. So they have, what I really like is they have this main that is separate from the actual load center itself. And because it's alternative power sources, they give you a few different options. So you notice there's a two-section panel. So this is the top section. Right down here, you have an ability to control the top section with a main, and then you get another 110 amp main for the bottom section. If you look at the numbers here, you can see they actually give you 60 spaces. So a lot of other panels out there, a lot of, you know, QO panels, they'll have like a 40 space panel or a 42 space panel on their 225 amp panels, 30 space, stuff like that. So that's what's cool about it, is that it gives you a ton more space, but it also breaks it up into an upper and a lower. It comes with a surge protector already, so I think that's awesome. It has a whole house surge protector. Those are the same surge protectors that I use pretty exclusively. I'll show you once I open this all up in a second. There's no actual wires to it. This thing just snaps in place. Down here you have a service receptacle, so they give you a WRTR 20 amp receptacle, so if you would need to plug in power or anything like that, you can do that down here. They also give you a knockout, so you can put a receptacle in here. If you have a portable generator and you want to hook like a manual transfer switch or an automatic transfer switch up to this, you can do all of that. So let's open it up, kind of see what the guts look like inside. That's section one. That's section two. That's the main breaker. This is the solar CTs. And This is a Wiser energy monitor that actually comes with this. If you guys are not familiar, I actually have another video where I installed one of these at my house. It's really cool. It allows your entire electrical system to be seen on an app so you can see what your energy usage is. You can see what are the prime loads that are running throughout the day. You can see when certain loads turn on, turn off. And then there's some connected wiring devices that I also did a video on recently that are Schneider Electric connected wiring devices. So each specific device can be seen on this app versus you just seeing entire loads. As before, it was just entire loads, but now they actually have specific devices that you can coordinate with this through Wi-Fi. So this is really cool that it comes with that as well. So it's just monitoring. It's kind of like stepping everything up. It's monitoring, it's adding alternative energy sources to it, and it's putting everything into one enclosure. This box right here, these are the donuts. So you actually hook these donuts up. There's a set of solar donuts if you're hooking up to solar power. And then there's regular donuts that you would hook up to the feeders if you're trying to monitor your incoming power. But all of this stuff just hooks up right into this Wiser energy monitor. And then you hook it to your Wi-Fi and boom, you have your entire electrical system on your phone and you can see in real time what it's doing. All right, so then let's look at some of the breakers. So this is a plug-on neutral system. So you can tell this is a 225 amp rated bus. So yes, it's a 200 amp main. That main breaker is 200 amps, but we have 210 amp breakers giving you a total of 225 amp bus. But what's cool is everything's plug-on neutral now. So Schneider has kind of moved into a plug-on neutral style. So all of your arc fault breakers, you don't have any of these crazy pigtails that you gotta like straighten out and run all these crazy wires. The neutrals are already hooked up. You can see that they're connected. This is our neutral bus up here and they're connected to these down here. So even like surge protector, this is making contact with neutral. So you don't actually have, it's wired into the two L1 and L2, your two hots, but it also makes contact with neutral. So you don't need any wires. Everything is run full circuit through this surge protector. They of course have all of their grounds bonded to the neutral. So that is one thing, because this is a service rated enclosure and this is at the service where the first main disconnecting or the first means of disconnection are by code, you're supposed to bond your neutrals and your grounds at this point. So it already comes bonded. They have a conductor dependent bond. So they run these huge conductors in between each one of these just to make sure that they're not using the enclosure as the way for fault current to travel in a fault setting, but they actually run a conductor to ensure that bond between everything. So I really like that. So as you can see, this is really a great setup for if you have any alternative energy needs. So basically, if you have utility power, you can have utility power come into this. If you have solar, you can bring solar into this. You could maybe have all of your solar loads come into one thing. You've got the solar kits on here. If you also have a backup generator or you have backup batteries, like a UPS system, you could do the same thing. A lot of times what we do is when we install panels in the house, I'll have like all of our power for like main things that I would want backed up on a generator being fed from a transfer switch. And then right next to it, I'll have utility power that feeds like other loads that are, you know, not as essential. So I'll keep some things running out of the generator specifically through the transfer switch. They're still running on utility power, but if the transfer switch kicks over and that generator needs to kick over to one panel, all of my essential loads are running one panel. So the cool thing is that it kind of mimics that setup here where you can have one panel that's maybe non-essential loads, one thing that is essential loads, one thing that's backed up, one thing that's specifically utility. There's a whole bunch of different ways in which you can do this, but I think all in all, this is probably the coolest panel that I've ever seen. The only thing about it that's kind of a bummer is just how heavy it is. Like seriously, I think this takes like four dudes to lift. But when you take into consideration how many enclosures you have on the wall to be able to do the same kind of setup where everything is separate, you could be talking like 4 to 6 different enclosures and all of these different things that you're gonna have to spend a whole day out there building multiple enclosures. So I think price-wise, it's probably more price conscious to be able to do everything in one. And it's gonna save you time because you only have one thing to install rather than all of these separate little features. So go out and get you one. Like I said, they're gonna have a remodel version of this that's coming in. This is the new construction model. Oh, we didn't talk about the bottoms. So check out the knockouts. One thing before we go. They give you a whole bunch of different options. So, you know, you've got half inch, three quarter, 1 inch, you've got up to 1.25 inches, 1.5 inches. To get into the main enclosure, up to 3 to get into the utility side. And then on the top, you get a whole bunch of different options, but pretty much 1/2 inch and 3/4 because you're gonna be running branch circuits most of the time into this. But if you do have a large feeder, they do give you up to 1.5 inches coal. So that's pretty cool. So all in all, this is your Schneider Energy Center QO Square D Energy Center. What do you think? And like I said before, if you want to check out the Wiser Energy Monitor, click here. If you want to check out the connected wiring devices that all sync up with all of this stuff through the app, click on this video here. Love you crazy people. I'll see you in the next one.